They say it takes 10,000 hours to master a skill, but the piano professor says it should take a lot less. It's all about how you practice, not how long. That's what we focus on. Now, let's look at today's video.
The question, how do I play scales on both hands simultaneously on piano? I've never been especially good at this, but the really short answer is, very carefully. The slightly less short answer is, it's different for different keys. The long, detailed answer is as follows. You may notice that keys that have the same fingerings are shaded the same, but that's for major keys. Minor keys will be a little different, but you should be able to find a chart somewhere for that. The standard exercise is to practice these, each hand one octave apart, for two octaves. Typically when you start the second octave you cross your hand over for the second knot of the scale. So for example if you are playing C with your left hand, you'd follow the pattern above for the first octave then play the D in the second octave with your ring finger and go from there. This sounds cumbersome but it actually feels pretty natural for most keys. Practice these slowly at first, then gradually speed up until you can do them without thinking about it or looking at your hands. You will probably need to start by learning the patterns one hand at a time. This will take you a long time. You might be able to master one or two a week if you have enough time to practice every day. You might not. Don't feel bad if not. It can take a really long time to build up this coordination, especially if you don't have much experience playing music. Piano technique is a pretty deep topic, and like any instrument it takes a long time to get any good at. I'm not really a piano player, so I never did all that homework, but if you are motivated you can do amazing things. Learning these fingerings will go a long way towards laying a basic foundation for other piano skills, so it's absolutely worth learning these if you want to get good at it. I've just realized this chart presupposes that you know what notes are in each of these scales. If you don't know that, the information is pretty widely available. Google it well. Learning the piano without spending decades on it is about working smart, not hard. You can access the Piano Professor Pack in the link below. It focuses on abusing diminishing returns to get the best results possible.